When routing piping from equipment, the process begins by selecting the nozzle to connect to and identifying the continuation grip on the pipe. Plant 3D will automatically choose the correct flange or connection required. Start building the structure and equipment models by adding some piping. Open drawing 05-03 and identify the pump you'll be working with, focusing on pump 503B. Hover over the equipment to confirm its designation. Ensure dynamic input is enabled, which can be toggled via the customization menu in the lower left corner of the AutoCAD interface. Enabling this option adds a dynamic input toggle to the tray, allowing you to display dimensions on screen or hide them as needed. To connect to the pump, hover over the nozzle to identify it. For example, if it's a 6-inch, 300-pound nozzle, set the pipe size to 6 inches, specify the CS300, and assign a line number, such as 300. Clicking the continuation grip on the equipment lets you begin running the pipe, with Plant 3D automatically applying the correct nozzle, flange, bolts, and gaskets. Dynamic input allows precise dimensioning during piping. For example, you can run a horizontal pipe 24 inches, adjust the compass using Control right click to switch direction, and then create a vertical run of 15 feet. The compass tool ensures proper alignment for subsequent connections, such as a 30-foot horizontal extension. For additional configurations, such as connecting to a tank like 503, identify the nozzle details, example 6-inch, 150-pound, and adjust the settings accordingly. Set a new line number, such as 400, and use continuation piping to route from the bottom of the tank to the target location, which is the horizontal vessel over here. Here's another useful trick. I want to align this pipe with the nozzle. If polar tracking is enabled, indicated by the icon turning blue, you won't need to manually calculate the distance. Simply drag the pipe across and move the cursor upward until it aligns with the nozzle. As you hover, a green line will appear, signaling alignment with the nozzle's centerline. This line acts as a visual guide, ensuring precise placement. Once aligned, click to set the position and extend the pipe vertically by 12 feet. The result will be a perfectly aligned pipe with the nozzle. You can stop the line here or add more components directly, rather than continuously running piping. I'll hover over this nozzle to examine the details. Here we can see it's an 8-inch, 300-pound flange. I'll go ahead and change the setting to 300 for alignment. I'm going to select a weld neck flange from the tool palette, a 300-pound weld neck flange, and place it right here. If we zoom in, you'll notice a small node point. Make sure your snaps are enabled, especially the node snap, to ensure it connects to the nozzle's center. Once placed, you'll see it automatically includes bolts and gaskets, completing the connection to the vessel. Now to connect to this line, I'll use a reducer since we need to reduce from 8 inches to 6 inches for the existing pipe. I'll manually place a concentric reducer by selecting it from the fittings. I'll position it until it snaps to the node. Let's confirm it's an 8x6 reducer by checking the Properties tab. Next, I'll demonstrate the auto-route feature. It's useful for simple routes, though I recommend verifying the results. I'll start by continuing the pipe at 6 inches with a 150-pound rating. Instead of calculating the distance manually, I'll let auto-route handle it. I'll pull the pipe up, select the node on the top of the pipe, and let Plant 3D generate a suggested route. You'll see multiple options, two in this case. If we want to explore alternatives, we can click Next to cycle through them. Let's go with the best option provided. We've added some piping to our model, connected a few pieces of equipment, and explored different routing options. By now, I hope you're getting more comfortable using the compass, understanding the grips, and working with dynamic input. Remember, practice is key when it comes to mastering this software.